Hey folks, Rob here, looking a bit wild and woolly, but we are up at the block. We've had a fair bit of rain here, thought we'd go for a little walk, put in some leaky weirs, made a few mistakes. One of them hasn't held overnight, but all a learning process, so we shall see how it goes. But I'm sure lots of yous will enjoy the green and the sound of running water. So, walking along a little track, take a bit of time, and mountains run up there. We own right to the top of those mountains up there. We basically own two big valleys, converge into one creek down there, running a bit of water. Faithful dog. If this works and you enjoy walking from your couch, we might do a few more just bushwalk type things. Certainly too wet to drive machines at the minute. I'll try not to talk all the time so you can see the birds and the frogs and whatnot. So this here is all backed up on that little leaky weir just there. As you can see, it's blown out on that side. Had a big surge of water here a couple of hours ago. It actually went under. So it was very much just a little have a go at it. I didn't put anything to stabilise the bank, and it is only sand and gravel. So, lesson learnt, we'll spend a bit more time. But there is a log that runs across there, there's a couple of logs that run across there. And you can see it is still backing up a little bit of water. But there would have been half a metre of water backed up here a couple of hours ago. I don't think I can get away from not getting my boots wet here. But isn't it amazing? See water coming down the creek. You can see just up there where that bit of white water is where the other little leaky weir is. I went over there and tried to fall in. So there's no cattle in this paddock at the minute. Finally been able to lock it up. This is our only paddock that's got secure water in. All the rest of them rely on dams and holes in the creek. So you can see it's still holding just there, but it's that really sandy ship there just washed straight away when it surged over it or under it. I'm not 100% sure what happened there. Managed to get past that little part where I get my boots wet. Kelpie dogs with me. Don't really go anywhere without them. So, still holding by the looks of it. I was standing here and there was a huge surge. Oh, huge surge. A definitely noticeable surge. Pushed a lot of water over. As you can see there, it's not doing too bad. Holding back a lot of water, which is awesome. And you can see there's sort of a false bank on this side. I'm hoping the water will permeate all through there and give me a nice little spot to put a bit of silk sorghum or something in. How good is that? So for those that have been following, this is the bank that I did the track on the little Kubota digger. There's probably 8 foot of water down there, and all the way up. There, you can just see where it's rippling up there, where it's not holding it back. The idea of the leaky weir, you can see all of that erosion there from where the water comes in, tears around that bit of a bend, just keeps pulling that side out. The idea is to stop that by backing up enough water to slow it down and hopefully grow some sort of vegetation on that thing. What about that, huh? Picture perfect. So, the water's pretty inviting. Normally would hop in. Oh, what about that? Oh, does it get any better? Absolutely beautiful. Get out of here without tripping up a rock. Oh.
Alright, probably enough playing around.
Michelle, go for a bit more of a walk.
Well, that was refreshing. Wasn't going to jump in, I was just too inviting. Awesome.
I'm truly inspiring. I've been watching these programs on the leaky weirs. Because when you see what the Indian peoples are doing, we've got all these machines that can pull dirt up into piles so quickly, and yet they do it all by hand and just have absolutely amazing effects from slowing their water down. We might pop up here for a bit. I do a lot of walking on this block, partly because it's so steep and lack of tracks. Any walking tracks. What I would like to do is get an Argo, because it's too steep to be safe in on four-wheelers, and the type of soil that we've got here, a few different types of soil, but it's like decomposed granite, a lot of it, and the two-wheelers, as soon as they start spinning, they sink straight into it. Look at that up there, so green. Been a little while coming. The bomb promises so much wet weather from 12 months ago now, I guess. But only just broke. I could probably set up a camera somewhere and just live feed that. I could sit and watch it all day, that's for sure. We've got some amazing rock formations on this block. We won't get there today, but it would be awesome to watch the water coming over it. I imagine this would be something that I would enjoy watching laying in a hospital bed. Last year I spent a fair amount of time in hospital. I've got two things that put me in hospital. PSC, which is primary sclerosing cholangitis, which is a autoimmune liver disease, and Crohn's. Thankfully, I've been very lucky with the Crohn's, touch wood. But the PSC is, yeah, not been fun. Ended up with a liver infection last year and multiple flying doctor trips to RVH in Brisbane. So, the nature of the disease, it's only a matter of time before I end up spending time in hospital again. So it's not all about the viewers at home. Some of it is definitely about me. Here's my little digger. Busted arsed, rough as little digger. But we've done a little bit with it. Well, it's a cocky's gate. In case you're wondering what sort of gate that is. It's got a little bale there that wraps around that upright and pulls the wire tight. The tin on there is just so that the cows can see it. Because when it's open, which it has been more often than not, they just march through there. With a bit of tin on there, they know that it's closed. All right, I'm gonna crawl through there and we'll start on the other side. Yep, we're through. This was all covered in the antenna a couple of months ago. You can see there's still little lantana bushes that's in there. Is very invasive, poisonous to livestock. Just a general pain in the ass. And the sort of country we've got here, very difficult to control. We'll get there. Well, we'll never get on top of it. Just hope to control it. We can get across here without getting a boot lift. Don't think my legs are long enough. That's the joy. That's a nice strong looking rock there. Smooth. Alright, we'll settle into a spot there. I'll see if we can jump to that one. Oh, we're over. So this is the track we've been walking on, is the access track to the centre of the block. If you've been watching my other videos, you know we don't have a proper track down through the property yet. Even this track, as you'll see when we get up here, does not take us very far in. Oh, it doesn't get any better, does it? try and balance over those logs there, I guess. Lantana, the friendly little beast that it is. As you can see, little barbs all over it. Not quite wait a while barbs, but barbs nevertheless. That was a nasty scratch. So if a bit more crap was put up on those branches, you'd sort of have a natural leaky weir. And they do exist on this waterway. I think at some stage I'm going to get my boots wet. Try to delay it for as long as I can. In the end, you just have to accept it, I think. Get your boots wet and deal with scratching around for a bit. So, this is actually one of our main hurdles up here. Bottleneck in our main valley. You can see out there where Sid is. It started cutting in a bit of a track where the cows have been walking up. Up here. There's some not super gnarly rock formation, but more rock than you can drive something over anyway. Help us there. It'd be really funny if I fall over with my iPhone on. We need to buddy. Other recording devices. Whatever they're called. Name escapes me at the moment. Oh. I was going to walk up to the rock. We'll go up here, but the cows have been going and I've cut this track in. can look down upon it. So I can get the digger to here, and not far on the other side I've got the dozer too. But I ran out of time on the dozer. That was months ago. How well you can see it. You can hear it pretty well though. So I guess you ask what's stopping me from putting this track in, getting it finished. Seems to be three things in life that affect what gets done. Time, money, and motivation. Rarely do all three align. But we've decided to spend a little bit more time on the block here. I'm sort of motivated. That's where I love to be, so that's my motivation for it. On the money side, we have to see how that goes. I'm sort of a builder by trade. As I said earlier, I spent a fair bit of time in hospital. Made me rethink what I'm doing. But it also has meant that the big jobs, building houses, I probably can't be trusted to do because I don't know where my health's going to be there. So that there stops me from getting vehicles through into this next section. Bloody lovely though. Yeah, we've decided to spend a lot more time getting this block sorted. I've got cattle as well. I guess at some stage we'll make a video with cattle in it. I really need is all three things to come together, and they will. We'll get there. Oh, must be time to infantry up, I'd say, and just walk through the water. Oh, look, I don't know if you can see him. A little rock wallaby in there. Very happy to see those little fellas. There's not much movement here wildlife wise at all when we first came here. We've had this block 3 years now. There you go. For all you couch surfing bushwalkers. One of the greatest things about spending time in the bush, learning to be comfortable with being slightly uncomfortable. And that's what happens when you're end up walking through water. It is quite liberating once your boots are wet though, if you've got a fair bit of water to walk through. It doesn't matter anymore, your boots are wet. Tips for young players though, have a dry pair of socks back at your camp, in your ute, in your little grab bag. I run a grab bag. Usually got a few little bits and pieces in there. Torch, something to make a fire with. Bit of a shelter of some description. Thermal blanket. Water, of course. Not quite as gung-ho as some folks I know. I don't have any filtration systems or purifying tablets. We were walking fairly quietly now. All I can hear is my boots scratching. A lot of water coming down here. Oh, so this is where we got the bulldozer to. Probably turned a bit fast, didn't I? So there's probably only sort of 200 metres at the most. Sort of a little rill put in with the bulldozer accidentally. But it's still standing there and it's definitely backing water up. Now that I'm wet. Lovely little hole at the base of those rocks. When this water stops flowing, it stays there for quite some time. A little lantana and shit up through there. Like a 30 ton digger with a mulching head or something and attack it with that. So I really need you guys at home to comment if this is what you want to see more of. I had bugger all comments on my machine videos that I've done. I haven't done very many of them, as it's a bit of a task to take videos of machines and make it worth watching. I've done a fair bit of machine work since I've made the few videos I did. But the phone isn't really suitable for it. I need to up my game and get a drone or something like Andrew Camarada Dude. I watch a few of his YouTube videos. He's an American guy. Has lots of bits and pieces. And if you want more of this, you have to let me know. These are easy for me to make, that's for sure. Just wander out into this. Oh, it'd be really cool if we come across some cows up here. I think they'll be all right up the top though, on the hard ridges, staying out of the really wet stuff. So we've got, yeah, like I said before, decomposed granite type soils, and then we have some really heavy, some of these little river flats, creek flats, nearly black soil. The lantana there, absolute curse. I think it was bought in for its bloody pretty flowers and hedges. So you can see that, that's quite heavy, black soil. The rest is light forest, loam stuff. And then the mountains definitely run the decomposing granite type soils. Look at it. Gotta get the bulldozer in here and just give it a little run through. I think these little flats would just come up so good. A little bit of work. Under that great big pile of lantana, there's actually an old well. Sunshine as we walk out into a open area. There's another cursed plant, rubber vine. Talk about the lantana having little barbs on it. Get a load of the thorns on this thing. Look at it. Wants to reach out and touch another invasive species that we have to try to keep on top of. So, probably enough, I'd reckon. If you want more, you have to let me know. Cheers, Rob. See you next time.